हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज माय थर्ड वीडियो बेस्ड ऑन द चैप्टर जेनेटिक्स. फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक जीनोटाइप्स एंड फिनोटाइप्स. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस टॉपिक, लेट्स रिफ्रेश सम प्रीवियस टॉपिक्स विच वी डिस्कस्ड इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो. व्हाट इज एन एलील? अ वर्जन ऑफ अ जीन. Normally, every gene has two alternative forms for a character producing different effects, and these alternative forms are called the alleles. For example, there is a gene that controls eye color. One allele is for blue eyes, another allele is for brown eyes. So, there are two alleles of this gene, one for blue eyes and the other one is for brown eyes. How many alleles for each gene are in every cell? Haploid cells like gametes only have one allele for every gene because they only have one set of chromosomes. Do you remember meiosis process, children? In that process, chromosome number is halved in gametes, in sex cells, and during fertilization process, when male and female gametes fuse with each other, then the normal number, that is diploid number, is restored. So in haploid cells only have one allele. What about diploid? Diploid cells have two alleles for every gene, because they have two sets of chromosomes, one from mother and one from father. Clear? Genotype. The set of genes present in the cells of an organism. Set of genes which are present in the cells of an organism. Phenotype. The observable characteristics which is genetically controlled. Students, there is one trick to remembering the difference between genotype and phenotype. Genotype deals with gene code. G for genotype, G for gene. So, genotype deals with gene code. Phenotype deals with looks. You can take a photo with. P for phenotype, P for photo. So phenotype deals with looks. You can take photo with. This is a trick to remembering the difference between genotype and phenotype. Dominant trait. A trait that always shows up if an allele for it is there. A trait that always shows up if an allele for it is there, then it is known as dominant trait. Represented with capital letters. It is a rule in genetics to represent the dominant gene by a capital letter. So here capital letter B is for brown eyes. B is dominant, so it is given in capital letter. Now what is a recessive trait? A trait that only shows up if there are no dominant alleles present. Is it clear, children? There is no dominant allele. Is it clear? It is represented with small letters. Letter will be same. Capital B for brown eyes, which is dominant. And small b will be for blue eyes, which is recessive. Genotype. How the genes code for a specific trait? If the trait is dominant, it uses a capital letter. For example, capital T represents tall plant. Clear? And if the trait is recessive, it uses the same letter but small letter. For example, small t which represents dwarf plant, which is recessive. Genotypes always have two letters. Students, somatic cells or vegetative cells contain two alleles for every gene, with one allele provided by each parent of an organism. types of genotype. The three situations pertaining to any pair of genes, as for example, you can see purebred homozygous dominant. Purebred is also known as pure breed. Homozygous dominant. Homozygous dominant that has similar pair. The genes only have the dominant trait in its code. So, homozygous dominant contains similar pair. You can see dominant tall, capital T, capital T, both dominant. Homozygous recessive, the genes only have the recessive trait in its code. Recessive short, this one we will show with small letter. Small t, again both recessive. Capital T, both dominant. Small t, both recessive. So, it is homozygous recessive. And the third one is hybrid or heterozygous. Heterozygous means dissimilar pair. In this, one will be dominant and one will be recessive. You can see this capital T, small t. One is dominant and the other one is recessive. So the genes are mixed code. Genes are mixed code for their, for that trait. Is it clear? So heterozygous dominant with dissimilar pair, capital T, small t. So the plant will be tall because capital T is present in this and capital T represents dominant. Capital T represents dominant gene. So the plant will be tall. From parents to children, tongue rolling, an example of inheritance. Students, in front of you there is a pedigree chart or family chart. Now the question is, what is a pedigree chart or family chart? A pedigree chart is a diagram that shows the occurrence and appearance of phenotypes of a particular gene or organism and its ancestors from one generation to the next. So now you observe this family chart. In this chart, males are shown by square. Males are represented by square. Both are males and they are represented by square. Is it clear? Now see females. Females by circle. Clear? Females are shown by circles. Clear? Now you see both father and mother. Both are tongue rollers, because you can see that because both are tongue rollers, so their symbols are hollow. You can see this is of male, hollow square, hollow circle. Clear? So hollow symbols represent the usual expressed characters, means they are showing that they can roll their tongue. They both are tongue roller. Is it clear? Father and mother both are tongue rollers. Clear? And if this one is dominant, then the symbol will be hollow. Clear? Now we will see children. Of the three children in front of you, you can see that there are three children. Okay? So out of three children, two can roll their tongue. Hollow symbols are given there. Hollow circle, it means daughter, and hollow square, it means son. Clear? And both can roll their tongue. Okay? Now what about the third one? she is non-roller. You can see that circle, it means she is daughter. And you can see that symbol is given in solid. Solid symbol indicates the character being traced. Okay, so this solid symbol shows that this daughter cannot roll her tongue. Students, when we talk about non-roller daughter, the non-roller daughter in the family chart with genotypes RR, small r, small r, we know that from these two, one is from mother and one is from father. It means that each of the two parents is heterozygous. Heterozygous means capital R, small r, capital R, small r. Capital R represents dominant gene and small r recessive gene. Is it clear? And we know that out of two, one is from mother and one is from father. It means this small r is from mother and this small r is from father. Clear? So conclusion is that each of the two parents is heterozygous, capital R, small r. Clear? Now we will discuss another example with the help of Punnett square. Now the question is, what is Punnett square? This square is known as Punnett square. It is a square diagram that is used to predict the genotypes of a particular cross or breeding experiment. It is used to determine the probability of an offspring having a particular genotype. Is it clear? The Punnett square is a square diagram that is used to predict the genotypes of a particular cross or breeding experiment. In this, male is placed along one side of the square. You can see male. Male is placed along one side of the square and female is placed along the other side. Clear? One side of the square, male is placed, and another side of the square, female is placed. Clear? And the resulting phenotypes can be written under the genotypes. In front of you, there is a family where both parents are phenotypically similar. Phenotypically similar means tongue roller, tongue roller. Both are tongue rollers, but genotypically dissimilar. One is homozygous dominant. You can see male is homozygous dominant, because homozygous means both are capital R, capital R. So homozygous, and you know that if capital R is there, it means it is dominant. What about female? Heterozygous dominant. One is capital R, another one is small r. So if both are dissimilar, it means they are heterozygous. Clear? So in this example, both parents are dissimilar. One homozygous dominant and the other heterozygous dominant. First, we draw one square and divide into four parts. Clear? You know that one side of the square male will be there. So from this RR, we write here one capital R here and one capital R this side. And from female, one capital R here and small r here. Now there will be cross between male and female gametes. So you can see that capital R in this square, capital R, capital R in this square, capital R, small r, and here capital R, small r. So through this square, Punnett square, you can see that all their children will be tongue rollers, because in all capital R is present. In all capital R is present, which is dominant. So all their children will be tongue rollers. So every child has at least one dominant gene from the homozygous dominant parent. Is it clear? Every child has at least one dominant gene from the homozygous dominant parent through the sex cells. Clear? So you can see that 50% means here capital R. So 50% homozygous dominant, if we see children, then 50% of children will be homozygous dominant and the 50% will be heterozygous dominant. Our next topic is sex-linked inheritance. Sex-linked inheritance is the inheritance of a trait, that is phenotype, that is determined by a gene located on one of the sex chromosomes, either on the X chromosome or on the Y chromosome. X-linked inheritance. Hemophilia and color blindness are disorders which cause due to heredity, and these disorders are more common in males than in females. These disorders inherit through X chromosomes and these are due to recessive gene. Clear, children? These disorders inherit through X chromosomes and due to recessive gene. In this, males are more affected. Generally, these diseases tend to transfer from mother to son and father to daughter. Father to daughter, because it is X-linked inheritance, so father always give X chromosome to daughter, not to son. He gives Y chromosome to son. You know that XY represents male and XX represents female. So father always give X chromosome to daughter and Y chromosome to son. So father only and only transfer X chromosome to daughter. Mother gives X chromosome to son as well as daughter. Clear, children? You know that daughter has two X chromosomes. One X chromosome comes from mother, while second X chromosome comes from father. So only female can be carrier, not male, because male has only one X chromosome and one Y. So when father has X chromosome with recessive allele, then there will be no other alternative and it will only express itself and will cause disease. Female has two X chromosomes. If one is dominant and other is recessive, it means the state will be heterozygous. Then she will be carrier, unaffected carrier. Is it clear, children? Because male has only one X chromosome, so male cannot be carrier. Either he will be affected or unaffected. So only female can be carrier, not male. Disease never transfer from father to son because he gives Y chromosome to the son, not X chromosome. He gives X chromosome to his daughter. So disease never transfer from father to son. And this is X-linked inheritance, or defects are occur on the X chromosome. So father cannot transfer this disease to son, whether it is dominant or recessive. Now with the help of case 1, we will try to understand the sex-linked inheritance of color blindness. You can see that mother is normal XX chromosome and father is color blind. Students, as I told you that male has only one X chromosome, so male cannot be carrier. Either he will be affected or unaffected. So in this case, father is affected one, color blind. So this is Punnett square. You can see that from male we will take defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome, and in female normal X chromosome, both will be normal X chromosome. Is it clear? Now, what will be the result? Here you can see one normal X chromosome, one defective X chromosome. So, daughter will be carrier. Clear? Here, normal X chromosome from mother and Y chromosome from father. So, it will be son and son will be normal. Clear, children? Now, here, X, normal X from mother and defective X from father. So, daughter will be carrier. And here, normal X from mother and Y from, normal Y from father. So, son will be normal. Clear? So, you can see that daughters will be heterozygous dominant. Normal vision will be there because you can see that none of the children is color blind, but daughters are carriers, is it clear, of the defective allele for color blindness. Is it clear? Daughters are carriers of the defective allele for color blindness, and son will be normal. Both sons will be normal. Now we will see another example, case 2. In this, mother is carrier. You can see one X is normal, another X is defective. And father is normal. X is normal in this case. So, through Punnett square, we will see. From father, we will take normal X and Y. And this side, we will take mother's, this one. Defective X and normal X. Clear? So let's see the result. In this, daughter will be carrier. You can see one defective X, one normal X. So daughter will be carrier. One defective X will come from mother. Defective X will come from mother and normal X will come from father. So, daughter will be carrier. Here, defective X will come from mother and Y will come from father. So, son will be color blind. Is it clear? You can see defective X is there. So, son will be color blind. In this case, normal X from mother and normal X from father. So, daughter will be normal. And here, normal X from mother and Y from father. So, son will be normal. Clear, children? So, you can see that mother is carrier, not color blind. Clear? And father is normal. So, daughters will be carrier daughter will be there, one normal daughter will be there, and out of two sons, one will be color blind and the other one will be normal.